Hello everyone. I hope you all are fine, safe and healthy at your home. Okay. So let's start our today's session. In our today's session, I have brought the study of formation of covalently bonded molecule. As you all know that in our previous session, I have explained how the covalent bond form. Okay. And even I have discussed the formation of few covalently bonded molecule in the last session. Okay. But still, we have to do the practice of some more molecule and the formation of these molecules which are covalently bonded, the sharing of electrons. So today I have got the 7 molecules and I will tell you how do they share their electron and in what way double bond, single bond and triple bond will form. Okay, so let's start one by one. Okay, so first molecule, this is of HCl, this is hydrogen chloride. Okay, so now first of all you have to write at one place hydrogen and on another place chlorine. As you all know that atomic number of hydrogen is 1, so 1 electron you have to show in the outermost shell of hydrogen. Chlorine, that atomic number it is to be of 17, so 7 electrons are to be shown in outermost shell of chlorine. Okay, so it has to complete its octet and it has to complete its duplet. So what they will do, that will share like this. Its duplet is completed now and its octet is completed now. So if you will see, two electrons are sharing together, so a single bond will form and total 6 electrons are left on the chlorine which are not participating in the bonding, that we call them, these are unshared electrons. Or as we talk about the lone pair, lone pair, that will be in the form of pair. So if you will see, there are 3 lone pairs. 6 electrons means 3 lone pairs are present on electrons, and lone pairs are indicates that electron which do not participate in the bonding. Okay, now see the next one, CH4, we call them, this is methane, naming we will understand later on. So the single element is to be kept in the center, that you have to understand. Okay, now remaining hydrogen you can put around it like this. Okay, and they all the hydrogen, they have one electron in their outermost shell like this, and carbon, they are having 4 electrons in its outermost shell. Always we have to mention the valence electron. Okay, so now they have to complete their duplet because they cannot complete their octet, okay, by gaining electron. So hydrogens, they all are completing their duplet. Now the question arises about the carbon. Carbon has to share always 4 electrons because after sharing 4 electrons, that will be able to complete its octet. So what you will do, that will share these electrons like this. That complete sharing is to be shown. So you will see around the carbon 2 electrons are sharing with the each hydrogen. So that bonded structure can be shown like this. Okay, this is methane. Okay, let's talk about the carbon tetrachloride. So carbon you have to keep in the center. 4 chlorines you can put here in this way. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have to mention valence electron of chlorine. Then in this also you have to mention, let's see here, that 4 electrons are to be mentioned around the carbon. Now you see there, they will complete their octet like this. All chlorine, that will be mentioned like this. Okay. Then 4 electrons are already present around the carbon and they need to share 4 more electrons to complete their octet. So what they will do, they will share like this. One electron from the chlorine they will share. Total 8 electrons now carbon has got. So that you have to show here the bonded structure. Okay, we talk about the CH2Cl2. Okay, so you are having a 1 carbon you keep in the center, 2 hydrogens you can put like this, and 2 chlorines you can put like this. 1 hydrogen they are having 1 electron, and chlorines they are having 7 electrons in the same way, and 4 electrons are to be there, so they will complete their duplet like this. Okay. That is completing like this, okay, and carbon has to share four more electrons to complete its octet, so that the structure we will get is CH2Cl2. Okay. Now let's talk about carbon compounds. Those are having more than one carbon. How their bonding is to be shown? If two carbons are there, we know that carbon can show the cationic property, so that you can write the first one. Two carbons are there. Four hydrogens, so you distribute equally on both the carbon. One, two, one and two. Means we have to give two hydrogen on each carbon. Now you all know that carbon that has four electron in its outer motion. I have mentioned like this. This is a four electron also. Hydrogen that has only one electron. Okay. Now first of all, what will happen? You see here, hydrogen will complete their duplet like this. Duplet means two electrons. Okay. Now that will share like this. Now the question arises, how the carbon will complete its octet? Okay. So now what you have to show? Carbon, if it will share its electron. So four already it is having. Two it can share with these two hydrogen, and this that can share with these two hydrogen also. But after that will share in between also. So the sharing that will take place like this. Carbon has a share. So now you see here the total number of electron on carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Two it has shared with this carbon. Now the same thing that will happen in that case. Overlapping I am showing you properly. Okay, so you just understand. Here carbon is making a single bond with this hydrogen. Here also same that with this. But if you will observe that carbon and carbon, they both are sharing total four electrons, so that you have to mention double bond. So this is the case when it will form double bond. Okay. Now let's talk about C2H6. That we call it methane. Two carbons first you have to have these six hydrogen equally. You have to distribute it. Three hydrogen on both the carbon like this. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And that carbon, you know that six electrons, so that is to be mentioned like this. So that is very simple. They will complete their duplet like this. Okay. Now, as we talk about carbon, so carbon that will share. This is to be like this. See, four already are there. 5, 6, 7, and one it will share with this. And if you will see this, that will share like this. So in between carbon and carbon, one single bond is forming. So that the structure that you will show there, this is the structure of ethane. As we talk about ethane, this is of ethane. Okay, we will discuss later on. Now two carbons are there. Two carbons you take. Two hydrogens equally distribute on both of them. Okay, so that one and one electrons are to be here. Now carbon that is having four electrons, 3 and 1, 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that hydrogen that will share like this, that will share like this. So their duplet is completed. Now carbon has to complete its octet. Four are there already. Five that can share with this. Three more electrons it needs, so that will share like this. Now you can see there 3, 3, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, same it will be done with this also. 3, 3, 6 and 7, 8. So 3, 6 electrons are participating in the bonding. So the structure of C2H2 that will be of like this. Okay, I think you all have got. Okay, try to make in your notebook yourself also. And the next one, it is of CO2 carbon dioxide. Let's suppose you have to keep set in the central carbon. Oxygen you have to take here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons are present in our outer shell of oxygen. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are to be there. So oxygen needs two more electrons, so their sharing will be like this. And this oxygen also needs two more electrons to complete this octet. But carbon already is having four electrons. Four more it needs. So what it will do? It share these electrons in this way. Now you can see in the octet of carbon is completed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So carbon makes double bond with this oxygen and this oxygen also, and unshared electrons.